least easy tip is going to make a difference in your color grading process. This is the cherry on top, the icing on the cake. It's kind of like a cheat code, really. What's up, everyone? I'm Neat, and I want to welcome those of you guys who recently subscribed to the channel. I appreciate you. It means a lot. And I promise you guys, I'm going to do my best to continue to make valuable content consistently every week on this channel. Let's not overpromise. After you color correct your footage and maybe even added a look, what if I tell you that we can tweak the footage a little bit so that the focus will be even more on the subject we want the audience to focus on? Okay, let's look at this footage right here, and I already color graded it and even added a look. Now, science says that people usually look at the brightest part of an image first, so let's create a mask that will make our face the center of attention. There's a lot of ways to do this, but we're gonna use a curves adjustment for this one. And let's add a shape mask. Adjust a mask to fit our head. And of course, you can also adjust the feather, which is the outside circle, if you need to do that. And then click on tracker. The tracker will be automatically attached to the mask. And all you have to do is to click on analyze, and Final Cut Pro will do the rest. It will track forward and backward. And when it's done tracking, this mask will stay on her face, even if she moves in this video. Now we can make changes inside this mask. We can lift the midtones and it will make her face brighter, but it can also make her face washed up if you're not careful. This is actually why I don't recommend this method. So you might be asking, like, why am I showing you this method, right? And that's because it's very tempting. It's very tempting to use this method because it can work. It can actually work. But it's actually better to make changes outside of the mask instead of inside, because the footage, you've done all the color correcting already. So that means the footage is correctly exposed. That's why when you increase the brightness inside, you might end up overexposing the highlights or making the midtones look washed. So click on outside and drag the Luma curve down until you're satisfied. And look at the difference. Small edit, very subtle, but can make a big difference. Here's another example, using the color wheels adjustment this time. After tracking her face, I reduced the exposure on the outside of the mask using the right side of the global wheel, and here is the result. That looks pretty good. Okay, I wanna be honest really quick. Color grading is very subjective, and that's because it heavily depends on the vision of the director or the content creator. So, I mean, do what works for you, man. Do what works for you. Edit inside the mask if that's what works for you. Just make sure that all the changes that you do during this process will not undo the color correcting process that you did before you color grade. Unless it's a creative choice to overexpose, to desaturate, or to do whatever you want as a creator, always try to maintain that base color correcting. Yeah, and that's it. If you guys got any value from this video, subscribe and go check out these tips on color grading, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.